Hi everyone. In this tutorial, we will show you how you can use voiceaiwrapper to connect your VAPI voice APIs. And you can white label the whole service under your brand. You can onboard your own clients and mark up voice minute cost. This is going to be relevant if you are a VAPI user and you're figuring out ways to brand this service under your brand and control billing. It is also going to be relevant if you are a individual user and you want to use VAPI voice APIs but need built-in automations for outbound and inbound campaigns and other integrations out there. This is also going to be relevant for you if you are already white labeling voice API providers and are using some other platforms. There's a comparison on our website, voiceaiwrapper.com, towards the footer. And we have done comprehensive research and looked up other products before creating our workflows. So let's dive in and I'll show you how our VAPI integration works. Okay, I'm inside my voiceaiwrapper account and you would be on this page if you have signed up for one of our free trial accounts and you've gone through the onboarding questions. I'll give you a basic overview of the product and then we'll get into details about the different features and functionalities. So on the left-hand side, you see your account level controls. This is your admin console. So this is the account level controls. And then you can add multiple voice providers, including VAPI, using this option. You just add your VAPI org key and your keys, org name and your keys, and your VAPI account is going to get connected. You can add multiple VAPI orgs this way. Right? Once you've done this, you will see a card like this. Now, when you have any voice API like VAPI connected, you can go into the API-specific controls. Yeah. So for now, I'll go back to the account level controls. And the first step for an agency that is trying to white label the platform is to add their domain. And you can do it here. You can add your brand assets. By the way, there's a tutorial video on every feature. So if you have any questions, you can either watch the tutorial, you can reach out to us via chat support, or you can go to the help section. There are detailed videos and also an option to book a call with us. All right, so assuming we've connected your domain and your brand assets, the next step would be to connect your Stripe keys. You can, of course, bill your clients offline, but connecting your Stripe keys allows you to create products which get billed directly to your Stripe account. Now, to onboard clients, you'll go to the client account section, and this is how you add client accounts. Every time you add a client and add their email, it'll automatically create a customer in your Stripe account due to the integration. Inside your client account, you can then add users. This is the username and password that your client users are gonna use to log into the client portal. You also have an option to decide what assets you wanna give them access to. So if you have a specific agent or a campaign that you have created and you want them to be available in this client account, you can choose it here. You can also go ahead and decide whether you want clients to be able to view these assets, right? So as long as you associate the assets in the client account, they will work, but they won't be able to view it if you disable client access here. Right, so last stop is to activate a plan on the client account. So I'll quickly head over to products for that. So inside the product section, after you've connected Stripe, you can add multiple product types. You can bill in multiple currencies and there are various pricing models to choose from. One model is the usage-based model. So let's say you've been charged 10 cents per minute by your provider. You can decide to mark up the cost and charge your clients at 20 cents per minute. There's an option here to include this product in SaaS Creator. I'll explain what SaaS Creator means or how it works in a bit. The next pricing option that you can see here is subscription plus overage. This is in case you want to charge a monthly subscription fee and maybe you want to add a few minutes to the subscription. And then beyond those minutes, you want to charge them an overage fee. You can also give your clients an option to just pay your subscription fee and then buy usage packs for voice minutes. Yeah, and you can set up usage packs here. It's pretty straightforward. all you need to do is give it a name and mention how many minutes to get for what price. Okay, so once you've created your product, this gets added to your product catalog. It does not get associated to your client account automatically. You have full control on deciding which client gets what. So if you head over to your client account, you head over to billing, now you will see your products listed. When you click assign to client, then this particular product gets activated in your client portal. And when the client logs in, they'll have to add the credit card to your Stripe portal. And you get this plan activated in the account, and you know they start paying for your plan. So this is how the manual onboarding process works. We have another interesting feature called SaaS Creator. Now this allows you to onboarding the automate the entire client onboarding process. So how this works is you can create a pricing table, and this pricing table gives you options to decide how your pricing looks like. It has text customization options. I've created a simple table for the sake of this video. So I've created a pricing table where I have a starter plan for $99 per month. And I have a monthly and an annual option. Now, you can take this entire embed code and embed it on your site. And whenever people come in and they click on get started or whatever you name the CTA as, it'll automatically create a client account, it'll automatically create a user ID, and it'll automatically allocate the plan, pricing plan to them, and it'll charge them automatically, right? So it automates the entire client onboarding process. In case you have a very fancy website and you know the color schemas don't match, all you can do is simply pick up the URL behind the CTA and embed it to any section of the of your website. Right, so these are the account level settings inside our app. Let's get into voice provider specific settings. So I've connected VAPI. Now, when I go to the VAPI dashboard, all my assistants are synced in voiceaiwrapper. Before you start using your VAPI assistants or phone numbers or knowledge base inside voiceaiwrapper, you need to hit this sync button. This activates a webhook, which basically is used when you are associating these agents and these assets to outbound and inbound campaigns. For creating outbound and inbound campaigns, you head over to campaigns. Now you can hit add campaign and select inbound or outbound. If you notice, there's an option, there are two options here. There's a single number and a phone number pool option. What this means is we have the functionality wherein you can add multiple numbers to a pool. And when you are running a campaign, you can associate that number pool to the campaign. And when the calling happens, that calling will be, those calls will be distributed across all those numbers in a round robin fashion. Right? So if you're doing high volume, if you're receiving high volume inbound calls or doing high volume outbound and you want, you have multiple numbers and you want those numbers to be spread over multiple phone numbers that you have purchased, that's when you would use a phone number pool. So inside campaign settings, there are options to add leads via API. So you can add leads, you can remove leads, you can also go ahead and mark leads as do not call. And this all happens automatically. You can also, this means you can pull in leads from a CRM or you know an external source, and you can automatically add those leads to your calling campaign. You can also dynamically real-time remove leads through that API. You can also mark leads as do not call while a campaign is live. And you can, of course, upload leads via CSV. Under campaign settings, you have control over which agent is calling. There's also a handy feature for callbacks. So assuming your agent is calling someone and they say, call me back in 5 minutes, you can configure a setting which uses your OpenAI key. There's a help documentation here. So you need to add your OpenAI key, and using that plus a few prompts in your agent prompt, the agent is able to call back someone based on the callback time that they have requested. So as we move on, there's also another interesting feature here, which is our webhook URL. Now, this comes in handy when, let's say, you're using GHL and you want your campaign logs to recordings, transcripts, etc., to be sent to your CRM instantly. All you have to do is create an inbound webhook and just paste it here. And every time some activity happens in your campaign, this goes directly to your CRM. You don't need any third-party intervention in between. Next up are call logs. So when you start making calls, this applies both for inbounders as well as outbound calls, you'll see your call logs. So everything that you see inside VAPI, your transcript, summary, recordings, they'll show up here. There's also an option to download this. Your campaign dashboards are also available to your clients, depending upon whether you have given them access, like I showed you under client settings. And then finally, you have detailed campaign analytics, right? So as your calls start flowing in, you get data filled up on these dashboards, and your clients are able to view how the campaigns are performing. So that's about it for now. If you have questions, there's a help section here. You can book a call, you can watch these tutorials, the ones that I spoke about right now. We also offer chat support. So as you can see, we respond in a few minutes. We are open to suggestions, questions, feature requests, and we are happy to get you started. Thank you, and happy selling.